Want to know how to do this on your Nintendo Switch? Adding in some cool controllers to play your most favorite games?
What's going on, guys? Dr. Brute7 signing in back with another tutorial video. So as I was showing you guys how I was controlling Zelda with the help of my PlayStation 5's Dualsense controller, this can be made possible with the help of an awesome sys module named Mission Control that is going to allow you to connect joypads to your Nintendo Switch. Two things to keep in mind before we move on with the tutorial: please make sure that you are on your latest custom firmware version. Make sure that you download the very latest version of Mission Control. Failure to do so is going to result in an error code. As we know, error codes are not fun. If you receive an error code, don't panic. Just connect your SD card, go to your Atmosphere folder, go to Contents, and delete the folder. That's going to resolve the issue. For any reason, if you get this particular error code, it is related to Mission Control. Okay, let's now move on with the tutorial process. Go to the link in the description, download the latest version of Mission Control. You're going to get a RAR file, extract the contents. You're going to get this folder, copy these both subfolders, connect your SD card or use FTPD to remotely connect your Switch, paste the contents to the root of your SD card. Just go ahead and overwrite the files. Alright guys, so here I am on the Nintendo Switch. So just activate your Tesla menu and go to Sys Module, scroll down. You should be seeing Mission Control somewhere here. Now it should be turned off in your case. Just toggle the auto start by pressing Y, and yeah, you should see the home icon. It means that it has been toggled to auto start. Now in order for Mission Control to work, your system needs to be rebooted. And after that, you should see that Mission Control has been activated.
Alright guys, so once following these steps, go to your Nintendo Switch, select the Joy-Con icon, and on the next screen, select Change Grip Order on this screen where all the pairing needs to be done. So let's just start with the DualSense. It's very easy for both the DualShock and the DualSense. It's the same method. Press and hold the PlayStation button and the share button simultaneously until it shows up on the screen. There you go. Just wait for the LED to blink in a pattern. It resembles the pattern of a heartbeat. Same goes with the DualShock. Press and hold the PS and the share button until it shows up on the screen. There you go. I don't know what's the reason with the Xbox Series X's controller, but for some reason mine's not pairing. It's on its latest firmware update, and you always need to ensure that your controller's firmware is on its latest version, but in this case it's just not working. Whatever the reason might be, I'm just going to show you guys regardless how to pair it. Press and hold the Xbox button until it starts to blink in a rhythm. Let go of it, press and hold this tiny button which is right to the USB port. It's going to start blinking real fast, and it's just not working. You see, it's just not pairing for some reason. I don't know what's the reason behind it, for whatever reason it is, but I'm not too much concerned. But yeah, it just stops with a vibration. But anyways, this is how you pair the Xbox One or Series X's controller, or the Xbox controllers in general. It might not be the same case with you. This is how you use Mission Control for your Nintendo Switch running Atmosphere custom firmware. So if you found this tutorial useful, please make sure to drop in a like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more videos and more tutorials. Dr. Brute7 signing off. Peace.